What do we got here? It's a little land heavy, but it's got two very good spells, including probably my best spell in my deck against my opponent, so I think I'm going to go ahead and keep this. Considering turn 3 V-Shaman and turn 4 Juggernaut, it's just a very good start. Fortunately, it's got one of my very few targets for Echoing Ruin, so hopefully my opponent doesn't have that. Drawing a land is kind of bad, but hey, now I can cast Tyrannax. Ooh, Tell Gelad Wolf. I like that. That gives me a 3-drop in case my opponent hasn't played something good yet. And Tell Gelad Wolf is going to be hard for my opponent to block here. So no mirrors, no cranial platings in hand. Though, opponent could be slow rolling cranial plating. It's not the worst to just not play that till you're going to equip it, because it's such a big swing. Not Spike Shot? Okay, Dark's doing good. That I can live with. Yeah, my anti-artifact deck is kind of good in this matchup. A lot of my creatures are pretty good against artifacts. I mean, that is what one of Green's things in this format, so. I've got a wolf. Let's see, if my opponent plays an Arcbound Hybrid and attacks, what do I do? I don't know. If opponent plays a Hematite Golem, that's a different story indeed. Alright, well, I actually don't need to worry about Hematite Golem for now. I'm just going to play the Outrider, because that blanks the Hematite Golem. Can't block the Tell Gelad Wolf. This way, there's no reason to play a target for Echoing Ruin if I don't have to, since if my opponent's got it in hand, it's just going to be a dead card right now. Next turn, I get to attack for 5 and play Fangren Hunter, which also interacts well with Hematite Golem. Ooh, Serum Tank. I like that card. But I'm on the beatdown plan. If my opponent wants to waste time casting or using Serum Tank, I actually am not going to stop him. All right, Echoing Ruin is also a good draw. Yeah, my draw is great this game. I mean, I drew a land and then I drew four good spells, so that's kind of what you want when you keep a 5-lander here. Hematite Golem getting severely outclassed by my creatures. Yes, my opponent can leave up 4 mana to stop the Fangren Hunter, but then I can just Verdine Shaman the Hematite Golem. Or actually, I can just Echoing Ruin it and play a Juggernaut in the same turn. So, I'm feeling pretty good about this. Hitting my opponent for 1,000,000 damage. Opponent's gotta have, like, Fireball the Fangren Hunter is probably, like, one of the best plays. Then I can just go Juggernaut Echoing Ruin and then still have a V-Shaman in hand. Also, after putting my opponent to 8 with my 2 hard-to-block green creatures. Green's all about evasion in this set, apparently. Alright, what's coming out here? Let's find out in a second. What's my opponent's best play? With only mountains and a Darkstone Gate, which can provide any color. I don't know. Volshock Warbore is actually not bad. That's, I think, pretty high up on the list, since now I can't actually attack with anything. I need to draw my Ferocious Charge. So, I actually didn't think I was going to be stopped this game, but opponent actually had something pretty good here. Let's just play a Juggernaut. Do I want to Echoing Ruin the Hematite Golem or the Serum Tank? Not really. I think I'd rather just wait. I don't think there's any profit in doing it now. My opponent might leave mana up for Hematite Golem, and if my opponent uses Serum Tank, I don't think that's bad for me. Let's see. So what if I attack with everything? If my opponent doesn't play anything, and I hit with everything, is that good for me? Well, we'll find out in a second. Flame Break? Jeez. That's a beating. Alright, I thought I was winning, and now I'm actually very much not. I mean, I'm not losing, but things could certainly be better here. Hematite Golem can get in. Could attack with Warbore, but I don't think that's advisable. Alright, let's take this damage. Got 3-for-1 on the Flame Break there, and I'm going to 14 now. So, a Ferocious Charge. Basically, I just need to draw Tyrannaxes. If I can draw some Tyrannaxes, then I'll be happy. Alright, let's just kill the artifacts here. I think, at this point, I am going to kill Serum Tank, since I don't really have a reason not to. Play Wayfarer's Bauble and I'll keep a land in hand and pass the turn. Alright, so things have taken a turn for the worse. Of course, I have 4 Tyrannaxes and opponent still probably doesn't have a great answer to that Tyrannax, but Volshock Warbore, basically a colored 5 toughness creature into a Flame Break was an impressive set of circumstances. Alright. Arcbound Hybrid. Sure. Can live with that. No, I'm not sacking upkeep because I could draw Tyrannax. Should have sacked upkeep. Didn't draw Tyrannax. Let's pass the turn. Ooh, I could draw a Wormskin Forger too and make Fangren Hunter into a 7-7. That would be awesome. Alright, what's my opponent got here? Fireballing the Fanger Hunter would be pretty bad for me. Ion Storm's pretty bad for me because it can now use Archon Hybrid to kill Fanger Hunter. See if that's what happens here. Looks like not quite yet. Alright, well, I'm going to sack Wayfarer's Bauble. Gonna get me a forest, probably. Yeah, I just need to draw some Tyrannaxes. Or some mountains. I do really well at the start of the game, and I have not been doing so at the end, which is kind of unfortunate, because now I'm losing fairly badly. Went from a pretty sick position to a pretty bad one. Or a pretty sickly one, as it were. Ooh, not trading off for the Fang Hunter. Interesting. I wonder what my opponent is waiting for here. One's got Mind's Eye and Serum Tank. Look at that card draw. Thermal Nav, okay. That's a thing. Opponent could be bashing me with this Volshock Warborn. I would not be able to do a whole lot about it. What am I hoping to draw here? Yeah, still Tyrannax. Tyrannax would be a 6 toughness creature, which is pretty strong. Doesn't actually kill the Warboar. Shouldn't have told my opponent that they could bash with Warboar, but problems if I double block, can shoot the Viridian Shaman, and then I lose my Fanger Hunter, and that is no good for me. What am I hoping to draw? Tyrannax. Sylvok Explorer, not quite it. Alright. Could attack with Fangren Hunter. Could have attacked with Viridian Shaman, but then it just gets killed by Arcbound Hybrid and then Thermal Navigator becomes a 4-4. At least this way, I force my opponent to do something potentially. And that's Trample. He can't block and shoot for free. Though, yeah, I'm pretty close to just dying here, which is not great. Alright, so it looks like Arcbound Hybrid is going to trade for Fanger Hunter. Or, yeah. You're sacking. The module still targets the Thermal Navigator, but doesn't actually do anything. I wish I'd drawn Ferocious Charge that turn. That would have been awesome. Instead, I drew Sylvok Explorer. Significantly less awesome. Probably just chumping the Warboar here. I think that ends up better, especially against an Ion Storm. I mean, I could still draw a Tyrannax. Telgelite Outrider. Alright, that's a thing. I mean, now I can double block the Warboar, which could put us back into top deck mode with my opponent having a Thermal Navigator and an Ion Storm and 2 cards in hand and me having nothing, but hey, it's better than just straight up losing. Let's pass. Hopefully my opponent's got all Echoing Ruins in hand. Juggernaut's good enough. I don't think it's worth siding it out in case of because of Echoing Ruin, but it is kind of unfortunate. Alright, well, I'm not beating Energy Storm or Ion Storm plus Energy Chamber very easily, but Tyrannax could help. Let's play the Nax and pass the turn. So you could put a counter on the Thermal Navigator, and then Ion Storm lets you ping anything. Goldmere, alright. Opponent could sack Goldmere and hit me for 3 down to 6, and then put Lethal on the play next turn. Might actually not be a bad play. It's not like my opponent's dying, though I guess if I could somehow remove Volshock Warboar, my opponent would die then. Not that I have a way in my deck to do that, but opponent doesn't know that. What could I go for here? At this point, a Deconstruct or a Barb Lightning would both be fairly good, but let's see. Just passing. Next turn I attack with the Tyrannax and just trade it for the Warboar, most likely. Yeah, if I draw an Echoing Ruin then to kill the Energy Chamber, then we're still back in reasonable shape here. Or not Echoing Ruin, Deconstruct, I guess I already used that. Barb Lightning would also be okay. My opponent targets Thermal Navigator with Energy Chamber, and I Barb Lightning it in response. Could be good. Alright, another Tyrannax. That's the card. I'm not actually just dead, right? Actually, yeah, no. I think my opponent can make Navigator a 4-4, hit me for 4, give it flying, hit me down to 5, and then shoot me twice, but it does not quite kill me. Ooh, we are just chumping here? Okay, I don't mind that. Might as well give Thermal Navigator flying. Actually, you probably shouldn't give it flying. What if I have an anti-flying card? Alright. Tyrannax. Drawing a steady stream of Tyrannaxes would have been enough to potentially win me the game if not for that Energy Chamber. Energy Chamber is dealing me a lot of damage here. So next turn, I'm dead, because next turn this becomes a 5-5, and then opponent can sack chamber and attack me, but I get to attack with everything this turn, which could force some action, I guess. If I attack with just the two Tyrannaxes, Warboar blocks one, opponent takes five. So I have to attack with these two also, then opponent can just block Shaman, so I need to draw something this turn. If I draw Deconstruct this turn, then I might actually be winning. If I do not draw Deconstruct, I don't think I'm going to win. Tanglewalker. Close, but not quite. Alright, let's just attack with the two Tyrannaxes and I guess the Tel'Jalad Outrider. Yeah, and leave the Viridian Shaman back. Because the Viridian Shaman gets blocked by Navigator for free, so might as well attack with the Outrider. Ferocious Charge may have done it also. Hopefully my opponent is scared of something and uses Navigator counters to kill like the Outrider, because you can use Ion Storm. Did not. Alright, well in that case I'm probably dead, because now my opponent is in such bad shape that it's just got to go for it. I didn't play the Tanglewalker just to hope my opponent didn't go for it, but I don't think that's going to happen. There are very few cards that get me out of this, so let's see what my opponent does here. Attack with Navigator, sack Energy Chamber to give it flying. Alright, I guess I'll take it, go to 4, and then get shot twice. Yep, so I needed to draw an artifact removal spell. Barb Lightning actually would not have... Actually, no, Barb Lightning would have done it too. My opponent's at 2, so... Alright, and there we go. Guardian Idol not doing a whole lot. Don't want Nourish. I have to be aware of Flame Break, which is kind of annoying, but at least I know about it now. Is Spire Golem good? No, Spire Golem's still just not good, I don't think. The Tanglewalker looks like it could be bad. Maybe I'll put in a Spire Golem instead of a Tanglewalker. Yes, this gets targeted by Echoing Ruin, but in a late game, I'd rather just have this, and it just doesn't look like it's going to do the job, so I will run that.